chi-square analysis. We will look at the variable nominal binary as the response variable. Then we'll look at nominal as the explanatory variable. To do a chi-square hypothesis test when data is organized this way, go to the Stat menu, choose Tables, and then the second option, Cross-Tabulation and Chi-Square. We have used this feature before just to organize the data into a two-way table. This time we'll actually perform the hypothesis test. Rows are the explanatory variable, columns the response variable. We can just display counts and then click the chi-square button. To compute the p-value and test statistic, check off the first box for chi-square analysis. You may also want to see the expected cell counts. Make sure to check the conditions. There are a few things to note in the output. This 5 is the raw data for those who are contained in the blue no option. The number underneath that, 5.600, is the expected count. At the bottom of this table, Minitab puts a legend. It tells us that the cell contents are the count and then the expected count. Underneath, we can find the test statistic and the p-value. What happens if data is already organized into a two-way table? I will uncheck the options for the hypothesis test, and we'll just produce a table of the raw data. Now we can pretend this is the only information we have. We do not have the entire data set below us. Minitab can still perform the chi-square hypothesis test. I'm going to open a new worksheet by going to File, New. Make sure Worksheet is highlighted and click OK. Next, into this worksheet, I'm going to enter the table. Everything except the total row and total column, which Minitab here has labeled all. Once the raw data is entered, we can go back to the Stat menu. Under Tables, this time we want to select Chi-Square Test Two-Way Table in Worksheet. We just put a two-way table in the worksheet, so Minitab can do the chi-square test this way for us. All we need to do is enter the columns and click OK. This time in the output, we do not see blue, green, red, and white. Instead, Minitab has labeled them 1, 2, 3, and 4. Also, there are three numbers in each cell. The first one are are the observed counts. Then Minitab puts the expected counts. Finally, for each cell, Minitab computes the chi-square contribution. So if we look back at the table, 5 is the observed count, 5.60 is the expected count, and the contribution to the chi-square statistic is 0.064. Then when we scroll down, we can see the value of the test statistic and the p-value.